What's really good?
What's going on? My name's Ryan.
I'm Victor.
Welcome to our Musical Odyssey.
Your music discovery and discussion channel.
Oh yeah. Today, I'm going to be having my brother listen to How Could You Leave Us by NF. I guess pills are more important. All you have to say is no. But you won't do it, will you? You gon' keep popping till them pills kill you. I know you're gone, but I can still feel you. Before we start, just want to let you know, if you tuning in for the very first time, we play the track all the way through, unlike most channels. So if you are not trying to hear the song because you've heard the song before and you're just trying to get to the discussion, we got the time codes down below. Hook you up with that.
So another quick heads up. Join us this fucking Saturday, the 9th.
We going live, baby. We going live.
Yeah, we're going to do our first live session, 9 o'clock Central.
Central.
I didn't put that in the last video. That's probably relevant. 9 o'clock U.S. Central Time. Saturday the 9th. So we're going to go live. Just a Q&A. You can ask us questions. We're also going to be asking you guys questions. You know, what you like about the channel, how you'd like it to continue to evolve, that kind of thing. So just it'll be a nice dialogue to talk about the channel.
Make sure you bring in something with you to drink, because, you know, we like our whiskey. You might like your beer, you might like your champagne. I don't know what you like. But whatever you like, bring it with you. We're going to drink, we're going to talk, we're going to conversate.
Yep.
But anyways, back to this request. We had an individual request.
We had a lot of requests for this one. On our last NF therapy session.
Therapy session.
So the question of the day was, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Was what track was of NF's was the most powerful? And this one, along with a couple others, but this one I thought was mentioned the most as the most powerful track by NF.
So. And I will say that. And usually I'm gonna go ahead and give the background history to it right now, just because my brother, you're gonna hear it in the song. It's self-explanatory. We're still gonna talk about it afterwards, but I'm the reason why it's such a powerful track, in my personal opinion, I believe it would be to everybody else that is such a huge NF fan, it was his mother. It's a song about his mom. His mom OD'd on drugs.
That's good.
Popping them pills. It's horrible. It's not funny. I've lost a family member to it before, too. So I can relate to the song. I can relate to the pain. Towards the end of the song, he actually is in the booth and he's crying. So he's speaking on the mic while expressing real emotion. So, and that's something that's to be appreciated about this artist in general. You know, he is a Christian-based artist. For those that don't know, I think that's something that we've spoken on before. Doesn't cuss in his music, so that's amazing. That's because most rappers, they just can't do that shit. They gotta throw the F-bomb in there somewhere, or somebody's a pussy, or somebody's getting shot up. But this individual, he speaks from the heart. Yeah, dude, let's just get to it. Yeah, NF, let's get to it.
Go on, I'm real quick as out here. I forgot to put in. Also, we've got a bunch of new stuff in the description beyond just the time codes. So just to save you the time of running through it all on camera, just go, if you're interested in the channel, definitely check out the description. Like I said, I've added a bunch of new stuff down there to help A, support the channel, and B, just the way you can be more involved. So
we've had a great deal of people that have actually been asking how they can help us out. To those people that have been asking, thank you.
It's You're greatly the shit.
Appreciated. You are the shit.
So without any more bullshit, we're gonna get to this track.
Get your bottles.
Turn your sound systems up, headphones in, whatever it is.
Let's get it.
Could you leave so unexpected? We waited for you, but you just left us. We needed you, I needed you.
Yo, I don't know what it's like to be addicted to pills, but I do know what it's like to be a witness to kills. Mama told me she loved me, I'm thinking this isn't real. I think of you when I get a whiff of that cigarette smell, yeah. Welcome to the bottom of hell. They say pain is a prison, let me out of my cell. You say you proud of me, but you don't know me that well. Sit in my room, tears running down my face and I yell. Into my pillowcases, say you coming to get us, then call a minute later just to tell us you're not. I'm humiliated, I'm in a room with a parent that I don't barely know. Some lady in the corner watching us while she's taking notes. I don't get it, mom, don't you wanna watch your babies grow? I guess pills are more important, all you have to say is no. But you won't do it, will you? You gon' keep popping till them pills kill you. I know you're gone, but I can still feel you. Why would you leave us? Why would you leave us? How could you leave us? How could you leave us? Why would you leave us? I got this picture in my room and it kills me. But I don't need a picture of my mom, I need the real thing. Now our relationship is something we won't ever have. But why do I feel like I lost something that I never had? You should have been there when I graduated. Told me you loved me and congratulations. Instead you left us at the window waiting. Where you at, mom? We're too young to understand. Where you at, huh? Yeah, I know them drugs that got you held captive. I can see it in your eyes, they got your mind captured. Some say it's fun to get the high, but I am not laughing. And what you don't realize and what you're not grasping, that I was nothing but a kid who couldn't understand it. I ain't gonna say that I forgive you, cause it hasn't happened. I thought that maybe I'd feel better as time passes. If you really cared for me the way you acting, why would you leave us? Why would you leave us? How could you leave us? How could you leave us? Why would you leave us? Our last conversation, you and I sat in the living room talking about my music, and I brought you something to listen to. You started crying, telling me this isn't you. A couple weeks later, guess you were singing a different tune. You took them pills for the last time, didn't you? They took you from us once, I guess they came back to finish you. Crying my eyes out in the studio is difficult. Music is the only place that I can go to speak to you. It took everything inside of me not to scream at your funeral. Sitting in my chair, that person talking was pitiful. I wish you were here, mama, but every time I picture you, all I feel is pain. I hate the way I remember you. They found you on the floor, I could tell you felt hollow. Gave everything you had, plus your life to them pill bottles. You gave everything you had, plus your life to them pill bottles. Don't know if you hear me or not, but if you're still watching, why? Why would you leave us? Why would you leave us? How could you leave us? How could you leave us? Why would you leave us?
Sometimes I think about things like, you know, when I have kids and like, you won't be there, you know, you won't be there for any of that. I'll never get to see you again. I wish I would've just called you. I wish I would've just picked up the phone. But you were here. I mean, you should've been there for us. You should've been here. And pills got you, right? And pills got you, right? I wish you were here.
A heavy ass track.
You know, the last track we listened to was Therapy, correct? Yeah, if I'm not mistaken. So therapy session. That song was basically based off of the conviction of a lot of other people's souls. Because when you listen to a lot of his music, this is what he's venting. This is stuff right here. It's his insecurities. It's his life. It's the things that he has genuinely went through. And then you have the critics of the world that hit you up and they're like, well, why don't you make something that's a little more upbeat? Yeah. Why don't you make something that's a little more happy? Why don't you make something that's going to be uplifting and upspirited? And that's without consciously putting themselves in that individual's shoes to maybe think this dude is, or this individual is genuinely hurting. For me, this is uplifting. It's sad, yes, but at the same time, like, no, I did not lose my mother to drugs, but I've lost a cousin to pills. I've lost a family member and friend to suicide. So whenever I hear stuff like this, you know, it uplifts my spirits to know I'm not the only one that has had to battle these demons. I'm not the only one that has had to get over a loss like this. I'm not the only one that has had to cope in life knowing that somebody that you're used to being around is no longer going to be around. You know, I'm not alone. It helps me accept, and that's the uplifting part, is it helps me accept. So
yeah.
Just because it doesn't seem like it's uplifting, just because it doesn't seem like it's something that could change in a positive note, does not mean that it's not capable of doing so. That was the point of therapy session. He was just letting his critics know, you know, you expect me to be happy and uplifting and this happy-go-lucky individual get to know me. Like, yeah, there's parts of me that are like that, but this is my real life. And what better way to get over my real life to get to that place than to just let it out? That's the beauty of being an artist to me, you know, anything that I've ever went through, just to let it out.
And the thing is people will criticize saying that, you know, you're putting a lot of negativity in the world or, you know, darkness. But the thing about it is, just like my brother just said, for people who've gone through it, it's cathartic, you know.
Yeah, it's therapeutic.
Exactly.
You help me.
So even though it might be a dark subject, kind of like Korn's track Daddy or something like that, but people who've gone through something like that, it resonates and it gives them an outlet.
And there's a lot of people that don't necessarily let go. You know, for me, I've had a chance to, and I've had the opportunity to let go of those situations for the better. Whenever I hear tracks like that, does it bring me back? Yes, but every time that it does bring me back, it doesn't bring me back with that feeling of depression. It doesn't bring me back to that feeling of being desperate. It doesn't bring me back to that negative emotion. It just, this individual has went through something that I've went through. I'm not alone. I'm thankful that I can move past it. I'm reminded that I moved past it, and for that, I thank you. People need this. People need good healing. People need negativity to get to that positivity, you know? Any growth comes in all sorts of shapes and forms. It doesn't have to just be uplifting and positive. Like, you can party and bullshit, but what does party and bullshit really do for you when you're hurting? It just creates more bullshit, you know.
It's a distraction.
It's a distraction. It's not
actually dealing with
You're not dealing with your issues, you know. Of course, nobody wants to hear anything negative, but my thing is if your life is negative, the only way to move past that negative is to face it head on to get to the positive. That's anything.
Yeah, you can't skate around shit.
Yeah.
It never works out.
Hell no.
Always, if you manage to get around, it always catches up to you.
Yep, and bite you in the ass.
Yep.
And that's honestly a great deal of why we have a lot of these issues that go on, a lot of these situations that go on in life. This song in particular, maybe his mother was going through something that she never really faced in life.
Yeah, something from her parents.
And it could have ended in her ultimate demise, you know? She wound up dying, you know? She could have had a bright future. She could have had more to give, and, you know, coming from this individual, we needed you. There's something that this individual saw in his mother, aside from you gave me life, that was a value for him in life, you know, and in a sense it was taken away from him.
Yeah.
I can't place blame. I can't place, I don't know the situation, but what I do know is that I wish that people would be more evaluative of other individuals' situations in life and more understanding. You can't necessarily 100% put yourself in somebody else's shoes, but you can go out of your own mindset and not judge and genuinely think step for step why this person feels the way that they are to get somewhat of an understanding. And that somewhat of an understanding, if you have that, you can help. Again, it all bases back to this one thing. You know, I'm happy we got to listen to this track just because I can furthermore explain therapy session, you know.
Yeah.
Stop judging individuals for their life or why they make music or how they attack their dreams the way they attack their dreams. For me as an artist, I vent. I vent anything and everything. I vent my own emotions. I vent other people's emotions. It's a way for me to get feelings off of my chest. What better way and what more? I can't think of a more therapeutic way to do it than to release it through song. We're artists. We're just as fragile as you as individuals. So whenever you're coming at us with your criticism or your thoughts, take a step into our shoes, or try to, before you open your mouth. Because you might not understand what we're going through in life and what we put out into the world because we don't want others to go through that. Or what we're trying to accomplish through putting our shit out. Because that's another thing, too. It's one thing to be an average Joe and nobody knows about you, and then to be just this person that everybody knows but doesn't necessarily know personally. Like, this dude, he reaches the masses. Like, he's got millions of eyes on him. He's got millions of ears on him. As we speak right now, there's probably not a person that's not watching this that doesn't know who NF is, and if they do, they know who he is now, and they're about to become a fan. Like, that's his impact. He would not have gotten there if it wasn't for his music, so don't judge. There is a lot of power in what we say, how we speak, how we portray our art. Try to understand first. Shit, this is on my playlist. It's been on my playlist.
Yeah.
I hear this shit all the time. I listen to
it. Yeah, I mean, it's a lot heavier than I expected. Well, I mean, I guess How Could You Leave Us was kind of, I expected to be a little heavy. Definitely didn't expect it to be about like his mom's death or anything. Yeah. Especially when, I guess I should have been a little more clear when I asked NF track was most meaningful to you. I expected it to be a little more along therapy session. I mean, it makes sense.
Yeah,
that's definitely a deep track.
And even in, like, you know what, you can't even just say this or therapy session. There's a lot of music by NF that just hits home. It really does. Everybody's got a demon that they got to deal with. There are very few that are strong enough to speak out and put their demons into that light.
I can only imagine how hard it was to actually release this track like that, you know, so raw.
No, exactly.
That's putting yourself out there a lot.
Exactly. It's like you're showing genuine emotion. This dude's in tears.
Yeah.
He's crying. Like, dude, I lost my fucking mom. Like, this eats me up inside.
Yeah,
and
to go ahead
basis.
And release
like,
that
yeah.
track.
Yeah. Exactly. But think about how many lives he's saving, you know? There could be a mother out there that's doped out right now that's listening to this song, and she's like, I'll never do drugs again. This is how my kids are feeling. But my thing is whenever you're in that position, like, you know, you don't necessarily hear what everybody that cares for you is saying. It takes somebody on the outside to hear it and understand it and comprehend it to be able to be like, damn, switch went off my head. This ain't right. Let me change it. Let me fix it. You know, so again, before you ridicule, and again, I'm as an artist, I'm always going to show up, I'm always going to show out, I'm always going to defend what I feel I need to defend. With this dude, for the negative critics, back off my dude. Or come to me, dude. You can get fucked up. I don't give a fuck. Like, seriously, back off my dude, because I'm thankful for it. This is shit that needs to be heard in the world. I don't care if it's too real for your ears or not. If it's too real for your ears, maybe you need to go sit in a room, turn off your TV and shut your fucking door and do some soul searching, because you got issues yourself and they root from whatever's being spoken to. It's conviction to your soul. So if it's conviction to your soul, let it be that conviction and heal and fucking move on and stop judging everybody else that's able to move on from their shit by simply speaking it out. Like, dude, this could save fucking lives. This has saved lives. I already know it has. Like, come on, man. You gotta respect that. For real. I ain't got nothing else to say.
You good?
Yep.
All right. That being said, my name's Ryan.
I'm Victor.
Thank you for joining us. We out.